Welcome back. This is another quick tutorial on motion graphics in PowerPoint, and today we are going to make this. This is the simplest animation I have ever made in PowerPoint, and I thanks to Neck Graphics who designed these 9 pictures for us. These are separate 9 pictures created in Adobe Illustrator by one of my friend Avinash. If you are serious about learning Adobe Illustrator, then I will suggest you to visit his channel Neck Graphics. As you can see that these are 9 different pictures, and we will animate them. So let's get started. Open a new file from the file menu and then click blank presentation. Collapse the thumbnail view so you may have more area to view. If you want guides to appear on your screen, then you can turn them on from view menu and make a checkmark on guides. I love to work on blank presentation, so I will change the layout to blank. And now we will insert those 9 pictures. Go to the insert menu and then click pictures. You can download these files, and the link is given in the description of this video. Select the first file, hold down the shift key and then click on the last file and then click insert. As all the 9 pictures are selected, go to the format menu, click the align drop down button and then click align center. And then click again on the align button and then click align middle. One more thing, go to the align button again and make sure this time align to slide is selected, and again apply align center and align middle command, so all the 9 pictures get aligned according to the slide size. To animate them, we use simple spin animation. Go to the animation tab, click the add animation drop down button and then click spin. As all the 9 pictures are moving simultaneously, so we will add a delay between them. Open the animation pan so you may see all the animations that we had applied on all the objects. First of all, choose the start type of the animation with previous. I will like to apply a duration of 4 seconds and open the effect options by right clicking on any of the one effect and then click effect options. I would like to auto reverse the spin, so that after rotating all the objects to 360 degree, they will get auto reverse to their actual position. I would also like to add smoothness to them, so I am adding around 1.5 second smoothness on both start and end. On the timing tab, I would like to repeat this animation 2 times. Hit the OK button. So what we will do now is to add a delay between each animation. So I am going to add a delay of like 0.05 seconds, and for the third one we will apply 0.10 seconds and so on. I am adding a 0.05 delay between each animation. This is a little bit slow, so I will shorten the duration length to 2 seconds and let's see what's happened now. If you apply a black background, then it will look a little bit different because it will hide those black design from the slide. So I apply a black background and let's see what happened now. So same way you can add more animation to these objects. Go to the home tab, click the select drop down button and then click select all. And this time I am again going to apply spin animation. Set the start type to width preview. I would like to tell you something about width previous and after previous. See, I want these animations to play after the first one, first set of animations. So either you can apply after previous, but that way each animation will be played after the previous animation stopped. I don't want that. So I always, most of the time, I use with previous and then add a delay timing. So it is up to you that how would you like to play those animations. Now this time I would like to select 6, 10, 14, 18 pictures and then open the effect options and I apply counterclockwise rotation, auto reverse, smoothness around 1 second, smoothness around 1 second on both start and end. And I will repeat this animation 2 times. Now let's see what happened. I will also apply the same effect options to the opposite pictures. And we'll repeat them 2 times. And here we go. To make it more attractive, you can also apply grow shrink effect. Select all those pictures and then go to animation tab, add animation and apply grow shrink with previous and add a delay. Open effect options and how much amount you want to apply is up to you. I would like to shorten the picture size, so I apply 90%. That will shrink these objects. Would also like to apply smoothness. Let's see. Little bit more changes I will apply to the spin effect, and that is I will select 4, 8, 12, 16 and 20 number of picture, and will change the effect option and will set them to grow to 105%, and again I will select all these pictures, and this is the last time when I will apply the spin effect on them. I want these pictures to grow and shrink while spinning. So this is the last time I am going to apply the spin effect. With previous effect options, auto reverse, smoothness around 1 second. And we'll repeat them 2 times. I hope you will like this quick tutorial, and I would also like to say something, and that is, this is the first video in which I am I am syncing the audio and video in real time. Before that I was using text-to-speech softwares, or I was writing the script before recording the audio. But this is the first video where I am recording the audio in real time along with the animation. So I hope you will like this video, and excuse me if you have problem understanding my English accent, because that is not my native language, and I hope you will enjoy this tutorial. Please drop a like and leave your comments in the section below, and to learn more about PowerPoint stuff you can subscribe to my channel, The Teacher. Thanks for watching and take care.